following program does not necessarily reflect the views of the management or ownership of KMSG-TV. This program is not intended to present the opinions of KMSG-TV or Singer Telecasters Incorporated, nor does it represent station policy. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your host of Personalities in the News, John Castle.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am John Castle. Once again, Personalities in the News is presented for comment and commentary. The purpose of this program is to bring to the attention of the people the affairs of state at all levels, local, national, and international. When conflict of ideas arise, debate results, thereby bringing before us more facts for our consideration. Only when the pros and cons of a situation are voiced can we expect the people to make more intelligent decisions concerning our future. Conservative and liberal viewpoints are necessary. If you have a question or an opinion, call it in and it will be discussed. Our telephone number is 225-5959, 225-5959. Taking the calls this evening, Lisa Veach. I would request that if you do have a comment or question, write it down first, then call it in, and it will expedite Lisa taking it down so that I may ask it of my guests. Before I turn to my guests and the subject for this evening, a word or two from those people that make this show possible. And I might add this, that if you like what you see here, you like the difference in media approach, like what you hear here, then support the people that make it possible for this show to be aired. Dr. Carl Coleman at 5151 North Palm is a chiropractor. And if you don't really feel well, you feel like you're just disconnected in every way, go see him. Let him work on you. Time he gets done with you, you'll realize that when you go in feeling like a ruined Bruin and you come out feeling like a ready Teddy, that you've had some really good work done on you. At least that's the way it is when I go see him. Also, if your car doesn't run and it just seems like it is not going to do for you what you think it should do, take it in to the All-American Automotive right behind the Blackstone Terrace Car Wash, and that's at Clinton and Blackstone, and take it in to Truman Sigler and tell him what's wrong, and he'll fix it. Just remember this, if it rolls, if it flies, or if it floats, Truman can fix it. Also, they have a special going there on mufflers and tailpipes and the 30 years of experience there in that field. And now to my guests for this evening. I have two guests with me, Mr. Roy Kendall, who is a real estate broker from Visalia, and Dr. Hartoon Nifian, who is an optometrist down there. Both of these gentlemen belong to the Libertarian Party, and both of them follow the libertarian concepts. And as you may remember, several weeks ago, I had Mr. Kendall on this show, and we were talking about the suit that he has against the city of Visalia, where the city of Visalia, in his belief, were misspending millions and millions and millions of dollars of public money. So tonight we will probably hit a little bit of both of those areas. So that'll be our subject for this evening. Welcome to Personalities and News, Roy and Doctor.
Good
welcome.
Evening.
Welcome. Okay, first thing I'm going to ask you is that, what is it about the Libertarian Party that you feel is different than any of the other political parties that from time to time we come in contact with?
Well,
either or both.
Basically, okay. Basically, the libertarian philosophy is one of freedom. And we believe in individual freedom and that everyone should function under his own free will. Now, there's a lot of ramifications of this, and we can go into that as time goes on.
Well, let me ask a question. If you believe in freedom, and each individual should function under his own free will, then do you believe that the government has the authority and the right, constitutional authority, to limit an individual in the right to keep and bear arms?
What the government has the right to do is...
Authority.
The authority.
Governments
yes.
have no rights. They only have authority.
They have the authority.
Right.
The Constitution says that they have no right to limit the bearing of arms by the citizen.
No authority.
No authority.
Limit. Okay.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Right. And so, but in a libertarian philosophy, that would say that the government has no authority to limit them anyway. As long as the individual has the gun, is using it for peaceful purposes, is not hurting anybody or killing anybody, they have the right to do what they want.
Would you agree then that the government, in that same concept, speaking of the gun, if a man misuses it, gets out of line with it in terms, say he shoots somebody, uses it in a holdup as an example, that the government does have then the authority to incarcerate the man and charge him and sentence him and jail him. You do believe that?
Well, under the present circumstances, yes.
Right. Okay. That's fine. Then that fits constitutional muster.
Right. The government somebody should.
Right. Okay. What else then? Do you want to add something to that?
Well, right? In response to your first question about the libertarians, how they differ from other parties, if I may, I'd like to read this preamble.
You're answering the question.
Okay. As a libertarian, this is the preamble to the Libertarian Party. As a libertarian, we seek a world of liberty, a world in which all individuals are sovereign over their own lives and no one is forced to sacrifice his or her values for the benefit of others. We believe that respect for individual rights is the essential precondition for a free and prosperous world, that force and fraud must be banished from human relationships, and that only through freedom can peace and prosperity be realized. Consequently, we defend each person's right to engage in any activity that is peaceful and honest, and welcome the diversity that freedom brings. The world we seek to build is one where individuals are free to follow their own dreams in their own ways without interference from government or any authoritarian power. Since governments, when instituted, must not violate individual rights, we oppose all interference by government in the areas of voluntary and contractual relations among individuals. People should not be forced to sacrifice their lives and property for the benefit of others. They should be left free by government to deal with one another as free traders, and the resultant economic system, the only one compatible with the protection of individual rights, is the free market.
Okay, you said that contractual relations should be free from governmental interference as long as the contractual relations are made between individuals. Mm-hmm. And that government has no authority to interfere in it.
Correct.
Okay, let's assume then, I'm gonna sandbag you a little bit. Okay. So not really, but it'll sound like it.
That can apply to groups too.
Yes.
In other words, groups, individual. Three or more.
I understand.
Number of people can
let's be assume that I didn't want to sell my property to you, mm-hmm. and I say to you, okay, I'm going to sell my property to you. But the only way that I'm going to sell it to you is if I put restrictive covenants in this property. I don't want this kind of person living next to me. I don't want this person there. I don't want to do this. I didn't work all my life developing this to give to this group or that group or this type of person. And that's a restrictive covenant. In your opinion, government has no authority to tell me that I can't do that.
That's exactly right.
They should have no authority. And yeah. If he does not like that condition, he could refuse the offer.
Correct.
Well, that's not the way the government operates it today, is it?
We know that.
Yes, we realize that.
Okay, you are a real estate broker, so
correct.
You know that. What are some of the things that government does do just in that field that you're familiar with that you think is not really a prerogative of government? Or do you wish to get into that?
Well, when government makes any restrictions or overrides private restrictions, take, for example, in Visalia, California, right now today, we have private restrictions that have been in, that private people contractually have agreed among themselves to restrict their area to single-family residential properties without any modular homes or mobile homes being built in their area.
Mm-hmm.
And it is a case, there is a current controversy in Visalia where, through state law, they have overridden the privately agreed upon and private conditions, the covenants, conditions, and restrictions, deed mm-hmm. restrictions, where people bought property with deed restrictions they knew about going in that said that there will not be any mobile homes on lots in this tract.
Mm-hmm.
And yet the city has decided to go along with the state in saying that we are going to ignore these private restrictions that you have voluntarily agreed to among yourselves, and we are going to discard them and say that they no longer apply, and that we are going to now provide for mobile homes to be built next to your single-family homes, even though when you purchased, you had an understanding, an agreement with your neighbors that this would not happen. I would personally object to the imposition of the state or the local government opinion that private individuals cannot openly agree among themselves what type of building they want their neighbors to live in.
Well, I understand, and I would have to agree that your evaluation of that is probably fairly accurate. But you also have to understand this. Almost no politician is going to let the opportunity go by to control real estate or to control property, because they make money out of controlling. And it's so easy to make money out of controlling whether or not you're going to get a particular piece of property zoned one way, whether or not you're going to be allowed to build on that piece of property. And remember this, when government takes the position of telling you what you can do and can't do, that's costly to you, because they take away your right to sue the guy that builds a gas station with a permit granted by the city next door to you that does damage to your home. You no longer have that authority to sue him. You can, but it's a waste of money, and you may as well spit into a high-speed van, because that's what's going to happen. When government takes your right from you, and that's what they do through these ordinances and through these building permits, and by granting the fellow a conditional use permit, they take your right away from you and they give it to the other person, and you no longer can sue successfully because government allowed it, and the man uses the government's permission to allow him to do it as the basis for his not being not being a suable issue.
Yeah, could I go beyond that?
Yes, please do go beyond. You're in the field. I'm not.
Okay. What is totally overlooked is the impact of government on poverty. And the easiest example, a current example in the city of Visalia that I'm well aware of, are two cases where private individuals wished to start businesses. One was a warehouse records on South Mooney Boulevard at the old abandoned Finney's restaurant site, which is a blight and an unsightly property. And the purchasers of this property, one of the conditions was that they'd be able to cut a driveway into this property for entrance in and off of Mooney. All the other properties up and down Mooney Boulevard have driveways in and out of Mooney. The city council chose to deny the purchaser of this property that right to cut a driveway in and out of Mooney Boulevard. This property was located on a corner, and they wished to require that if anyone wanted to come to this site, they would have to come in through the side street rather than being able to enter in and out of Mooney. A second project that was denied, flat denied, was in an area up on Goshen Avenue in North Visalia, where the purchasers wished to install a family billiards hall, pool room. Mm-hmm. And the neighbors complained about traffic and congestion, that nuisance, and this use of this abandoned or empty building was denied. So here we have two examples of government interference with private individuals and private property that instead of having productive businesses in the community, we now have vacant and empty buildings.
Well, of course, now the people that own the building can, since they tried to sell it and couldn't, they have a perfect right to go back and sue the government for loss of income and for loss of property value. The Supreme Court decision, I think, supported that. So they just need to go after the city for it, and then especially the individuals that voted against it, because they're not really covered under qualified immunity, not really, because they now know the law, or should have known the law. Mm-hmm. And so that'd be the thing to do, go after them under civil rights violations, if nothing more. They're so used to not being sued, mm-hmm. and they're so used to having the judge rubber stamp everything that they do, that they've gotten away with economic rape of the public, and it's about time that we turn it around and give them some of the same thing they're giving us.
Yeah. Well, if you go beyond these two examples, and go, for example, to the community of Berkeley in Northern California, where you have very stringent rent controls and building controls, all types of regulations on every movement of private property and private enterprise, you can see that here's a pocket of poverty. This is Berkeley, California, surrounded by some of the most expensive and highly developed productive property in the entire world.
Okay, we're going to need to take a break. Let's take a break right now. We'll be back in just a moment, ladies and gentlemen, to continue questions for Mr. Roy Kendall and Dr. Hartoon Nefian, but for right now, a short break.
Are you sick and tired of seeing your insurance rates go up? I know I am. At LJ Linder & Associates Insurance Brokerage, they know how to do something about high costs. Call Larry and make an appointment today. He can help you fight the high prices and still get good old-fashioned personalized service. The following types of insurance are available: commercial, industrial, life, ocean, home, auto, farm, and hospitalization. That's LJ Linder & Associates, located at 4991 East McKinley,
Suite 118.
Call 252-3774.
Ladies and gentlemen, do you like the John Castle Show, Different Point of View Presents, and a challenge to the establishment? Do you want the show to continue? If so, your help is needed. For the first time, it is necessary for us to ask you to contribute so that this show may stay on the air. Airtime costs money, and one of the show's major sponsors is retiring. Please send your contributions to The John Castle Show, 3948 East Gettysburg, Fresno, California. Any amount will help, $10, $20, $50 or more. We thank you in advance for your kind, gracious assistance and contributions. If you have been looking for low prices and high quality on custom upholstery, look no further. Come to Admiral Upholstery, where we specialize in furniture, cars, trucks, boats, and RVs. You can select from a wide assortment of colors and styles like Naugahyde, leathers, tweeds, velvets, prints, tapestries, and many more. So stop by Admiral Upholstery, located at 756A Halbert Avenue in Clovis, or call us for a free estimate at 292-5973. That's Admiral Upholstery, where we've offered low prices and high quality since 1965.
You have young personalities in the news. If you have a question or an opinion, call it in and it will be discussed. Our telephone number is 225-5959, taking the calls this evening. Lisa Beach, the line is busy, but keep trying. She'll get to you in a moment. I would request, though, that if you do have an opinion or a question, write it down first, then call it in. It will expedite Lisa taking the question down. Before I return to my guests on the subject for this evening, a word or two again from those people that make this show possible, and I would again repeat to you that if you like what you see here and like what you hear here, then support the people that make it possible for you to see and hear what you see and hear here. The Free Enterprise Society is an organization that most of you out there that care about America and care about yourselves should be joining. And I'm going to give you their telephone number, and you call Steve Hempfling and ask him about this society. Telephone number 294-0665. Again, I'll give you that number once more, 294-0665. They put out a pamphlet like this, Free Enterprise Society News, and they give all kinds of information in it, like this one on the back about a book, The Law That Never Was. And and these are just interesting books. And almost anything that you can find out from the Free Enterprise Society is worth your getting into and worth your knowing. And they deal with taxes primarily, but they deal with a lot of other things too. So give Steve Hempfling a call, and I'll give you that number once more, 294-0665. Might be the best call that you could have made. Also, this book, Target, America's Children. Get this if you can. I think the American Bookstore on East Olive may have it. That's in the Tower District. And this book deals with education in America, what has happened, what is likely to happen, and where we stand because of what has happened. And as you know, the educational system today in our country is almost totally kaput. Now back to my guests for this evening. To my immediate left, Mr. Roy Kendall, a real estate broker, and to his left, Dr. Hartoon Nefian, an optometrist. They're both from Visalia. So I'm going to start moving into the questions that are in. If I don't, we won't get through, and then I'll have all kinds. Oh, one thing that I need to add. Ladies and gentlemen, personalities in the news will not be seen after tonight on this channel. anymore. My show was canceled by the new manager and the new owners in order to give this prime time to a Mexican Mundo or something like that. I'm not real sure what it is. But anyhow, I was told by the manager that they needed my time to satisfy the demands of their new contract. So this show will not be on the air here after tonight. However, tune in on channel 49, KNXT, channel 49, next Saturday night, same time, same format. Well, almost, it'll be almost the same format, but just tune in on KNXT channel 49, and I'll be there, and I'll keep on trying to bring you the kind of guests that I have here. Okay, now to the questions that came in. Don't you think that a TV personalities and talk show hosts, no matter how obscure, have a duty to expose crooked police officers? Well, I would, best way I can answer your question is that if I know for a fact that somebody is dishonest, I probably am going to say it. And chances are I might get in trouble. But yes, I think that anybody in the communications media, whether it's newspaper, whether it's a pamphlet, whether it's a, no matter what, have a duty to expose that which is dishonest, regardless of who it is and with whom it's about. Okay, in Eastern Europe, the newly established democratic-leaning governments are learning that they have a very severe problem of how to run the government without the assistance of the established bureaucracy, which is overflowing with communists. Non-communists don't have experience running the government. In this country, don't vote we the people and you the libertarians face exactly the same problem?
I would say that would not be a problem. It would be more difficult to gain prosperity and gain what everybody wishes in the country when you have government controls there. So when they have removed the shackles of the communist government, they could look forward to a greater prosperity.
Okay, Doctor, don't you think that government should never do for people what people can do for themselves better?
Absolutely. And there's two choices. Either the people can do it themselves and do it better, or we don't need it.
Okay. Now we have, I'm going to give you another example. I'm going to ask you to give your opinion, and you may go any way you like on it. Matthew Garwin, who is the president or chairman of Americans for Americans, is trying to recall Bruce Bronson for voting to take away, in his opinion, the way he states it, the right of the people to keep and bear arms. Of course, they claim that it's just assault weapons, but it gives the government the power to add to that list anything that they wish, just upon application to a judge. And that and he's trying to recall Bruce Bronson. Now, question, do you think that that kind of a person should be recalled, or should he just be voted out at the next election? Or what should happen? Or should there be an initiative measure that takes away the power of all government officials to ever interfere with that right, including the judges?
It's in the Constitution now.
But the judges don't understand it.
That's
like you and I do.
Yeah, right.
They seem to have a mental problem with the English language.
I couldn't agree with you more.
Well, no, I'm asking you, is that a question? Do they seem to have a mental problem with the English language?
Well, I don't know that. I'm sure they understand English as well as anybody else. They just don't wish to interpret as the Constitution states. And, you know, if they are in the power and they are going to do whatever they so wish, the people still have the power to vote them off out of office, which is what they
except for a federal judge.
Okay.
Now, Frankfurter said this, and I'm going to try to memorize it. I'm going to try to quote it like I remembered it years back when a young lady from the Dallas Times newspaper challenged him on something, and it was some case that the Supreme Court had overruled a state law, and she asked him about the state's rights, the 10th Amendment. And he laughed and he said, the 10th Amendment, what's the 10th Amendment? You know, he's laughing, what does it matter? She said, well, after all, Mr. Justice, it is a part of the Constitution. And Frankfurter very angrily turned to her and pointed his finger at her and said, young lady, I am the Constitution. And the Constitution means whatever I want it to mean, whatever I feel it should mean, what I think it ought to mean at any given moment. Now really, is he really quoting the Constitution or quoting his own feelings and thoughts there? That's a question to both of you, you're libertarians.
Oh, he's certainly quoting his own feelings. The Constitution says specific things, and it's their responsibility. They take an oath of office to uphold that Constitution.
Yes, I agree with you.
They, in many cases, are not doing that.
Well, the word no, what does the word no mean to you then, and to you? What does the word no mean?
Well, the word no is an absolute no, that is a prohibition. I think in a historical context, what the justice was saying is similar to the king's view of himself at the time of the separatists in England, before the separatists went over to Holland, before coming to the United States as pilgrims. And that was that the king felt as though he was appointed by God, that he had a divine appointment.
Divine,
and therefore,
right,
that he had a divine right over the lives and property of all of the people. And what has happened, I'm afraid, today is that we have gone back to the time of the separatists in many ways, where we have conveyed upon our elected officials and judges the feeling or the attitude that some way they have some divine appointment, and therefore that they have an absolute right over the lives and property of all people.
Okay, there's another question that I'd like to ask in line to that, and this is a very loaded question, so think carefully on it before you answer it, and you might decide to not even answer it. There is a move on to get an initiative measure prepared and on the ballot that, for all practical purposes, says this, that any initiative, constitutional or statutory measure passed by the people that is declared unconstitutional in whole or in part by any judge at any level in the state of California, that judge will stand resigned from the bench, his decision will have no standing at law before the fact and not after, and he will forfeit all pay, all allowances, and all retirement pay, and never again be allowed to hold an appointive or judicial post or elected post in the state of California. And that upon certification by the Secretary of State, the passage of the proposition, it takes effect immediately, and the governor is directed, authorized and directed, to replace any judge that so makes that pronouncement, and that his appointed individual or appointed judge will stand as a judge for 1 year until the Senate finally confirms or denies his confirmation. Would you, as libertarians, tell me what's wrong with that kind of proposed initiative, if there's anything wrong with it, and why?
I can see a problem in that. What happens if the people pass an initiative which violates the Constitution, which violates the individual's rights?
Which Constitution?
The federal Constitution.
Okay, well, we're talking about state in this case.
Okay, propose an initiative, and the initiative passes, which violates an individual's rights. Then, if the judge, like what? Well, let's take an example of freedom of speech, for example.
Okay, all right.
The initiative is passed where you cannot,
If that were the case, where would the case be tried?
Well, to say that a judge that rules that unconstitutional shall no longer serve would not mm-hmm. be correct either, I would think.
The smart judge would see to it that it was transferred to the federal court, where the initiative measure would have no power. It only has power over state court.
That's fine. Any
power over the other. But anyhow, that's an interesting point.
I see when we talk about statutes or when we talk about what should be done, we have to look at it if it's a good thing or if it's a bad thing.
Mm-hmm.
And if it's bad to allow this, and we're going to say no, then we've got to say that same thing about a good thing. For example, if we're going to say that we're going to not allow pornography or something that we think is bad, then that same power can apply to something that we believe in that it's good.
And but isn't that what's happening to us today already?
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
And
that's
what's
happening
to us already. We should have freedom of speech. And if you have freedom of speech, then yes, the person has the right to say something that's bad, but I also have the right to say something that's good. And in a free society, the person that has something to say that's good can present his arguments as well as the other one, and whoever prevails, hopefully the good will prevail.
Well, I was interested in seeing how you would handle that. Let's take a break. We'll be back in just a moment to continue with questions for Mr. Kendall and Dr. Nethian, but for right now, short break.
What Westinghouse makes appliances? Very good appliances.
That's right, Fresno. The switch is on to White Westinghouse. Go in and see why more and more people are making the switch to the newest choice in appliance quality and dependability. With precision engineering, attention to detail, and a genuine sense of pride built into every White Westinghouse product, you get an appliance you can rely on year after year. You also have a wide variety of styles, colors, and features to choose from. Everything you're looking for, all at a price you can't afford. Your White Westinghouse dealer carries all the high-quality White Westinghouse appliances you want, so you're sure to find the one that's right for you. And with prices marked to move on selected refrigerators, washing machines, and dryers, you can't afford not to make the switch right now. Call Fresno Distributing at 442-8800 and find out the name of the White Westinghouse dealer nearest you.
Some people think the National Guard is just an excuse for a bunch of guys to get together and have a good time. That they're not as trained or committed as other branches of the military. That they're weekend warriors, not real soldiers. And people wonder what business they have being in a foreign country. Well, I can't clear up all the misconceptions people have about the National Guard, so let me leave you with one important fact. If you bring together all the ready forces of the Army, Air Force, Navy, Marines, and Reserves, you still have only half the picture. The other half? The National Guard. Skilled, capable, intelligent people. People like you and me. Americans at their best.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm John Castle. You're viewing Personalities in the News. If you have a question or an opinion, call it in and it will be discussed. Our telephone number is 225-5959, taking the calls this evening. Lisa Veach, the line is busy, but keep trying. She'll get to you in a moment. Before I get back to my guests and the subject for this evening, a word or two from those people that make this show possible, and I might say this, that if you like what you see and hear here, then support the people that make it possible. Goodall Carpet, located at Ashland and Fresno, of course, is the place for you to go to get floor covering of any kind that you might need. You may get the same kind of floor covering from anyone else, but you will never get the service, the goodwill, and the smile that you can get from Joe Goodall and his group. And also, the Blackstone Terrace Car Wash is located down on Clinton and Blackstone. Vern and Jennifer have it. Go in there and have your car washed. You'll find that it's about 20% cheaper than any of the other major car washes in town, but their service and what they do and how they turn it out is equal to that of any car wash anywhere, anytime. And now back to my guests for this evening. To my immediate left, Mr. Roy Kendall, who's a real estate broker from Visalia, and Dr. Hartoon Nithian, who's an optometrist there. They are both libertarians. And I'm going to continue with the questions coming in. How would you libertarians handle the problem presently facing the taxpayers of Fresno and their efforts to get rid of mandatory water meters in the face of a panicking council and city staff, which know that they are about to be caught in their past lies that they have not been using water rate money to support the rest rest of city government?
Well, very simply, number one, you wouldn't have a city-owned water company. The water company would be owned by private individuals, just the same as in Visalia. We have a privately owned water company. And a privately owned company has to have a profit which is a reward for efficiency, and of course the only monies that they're going to have as profit are going to come from the sale of the water, so you wouldn't even have this problem.
Would you support an initiative then in your area that would make it illegal for government to own any kind of business in opposition to private industry?
Yes.
Okay.
Certainly.
Okay, that's all right. Okay, what do you think about Friday's court decision from San Francisco that declared unfunded mandated legislation imposed by the state legislature upon the counties to be unconstitutional and equally ordering the legislature to pay the counties $400 million toward the cost of indigent medical care and Medi-Cal?
Yes, I would have to agree that if the state legislature is going to pass and mandate legislation on the counties and the cities, that this be properly funded also, and not to put the burden back onto the cities and the counties.
Okay, what is the libertarian approach to governmental use of computers to store data on the factual daily lives of American citizens, invading the privacy of every citizen? Government justifies this as a means of catching criminals, but does it to every citizen? Should government govern by laws designed for the criminals and the crazies?
The government has no business storing data on the individual citizen.
Even
there's
the criminals.
No reason to. Not on the criminals, but there's, you know, statistics. Keeps the statistics on the criminals.
Mm-hmm.
Criminal activity, but they have no justification for.
What is the libertarian position towards the state Supreme Court action letting stand a lower court decision offering one private citizen, a woman, to sue another private citizen, a country club, for damages for discrimination because the club did not admit women members and did not let her join?
I would have to say that as a libertarian, the owner of that private club and the members that joined freely have an absolute right to restrict their membership to whoever they wish.
Well, do you think that the judge that made that kind of decision is wrong?
Yes.
Did he do it by law? Was he paid under the table? How did he arrive at that decision?
I can't speak for the judge. However, the judge obviously was not a member of the Libertarian Party.
Okay. Well, that's as good an answer as you got. You could have answered it some other way. Okay. What is the Libertarian position on drugs? Is there a single position on drugs, or do different Libertarians have different positions on drugs? Well, of course, you've got to have different ones because...
Well, different people have
people.
Different opinions.
Of course.
However, the feeling on drugs, okay, is that we do have legalized drugs in America today. Two very common legalized drugs are alcohol and tobacco. And personally, I am not a non-drinker and a non-smoker, and as far as I'm concerned, always will be. As far as other drugs that are currently illegal, the Libertarian Party position is that if you choose to take, let's say, cocaine, heroin, marijuana, whatever, yourself privately and kill yourself, either kill yourself with too much alcohol, cocaine, or heroin, that your life is your own, and what you do to your life is your own business, and that it's the government's position to stay out.
Okay, then that would lead me to the next question. Assuming that this is true, and assuming that this is what you believe, and the heroin addict decides that he wants to take your money from you, and you decide that he's not going to, but because he needs a fix so badly, he tries to kill you and maims you, defaces you, in other words, harms you so that you carry the mark for the rest of your life, then what position do you take?
Oh. In the first place, he has no right to do that, according to the libertarian philosophy. He has no right to bring harm, as we talked about earlier, to an individual without his consent.
Mm-hmm.
So that would be an improper activity, according to the libertarian philosophy.
Okay, then how would you deal with that?
Well, first place, we have to go back and look at the big picture, that the government shouldn't regulate any substance that a person takes. You should not say that you cannot drink a soft drink, or because there's a lot of sugar in it, for example, or that you should not whatever substance.
Then you would not agree with the Pure Foods and Drug Administration, then?
Absolutely not.
Okay. So,
excuse me, if
sure,
I may
sure, go ahead.
Get
Continue.
Back to the issue of when somebody does something harming another person, whether he takes illegal drugs or not should not be the issue. If he produces harm to somebody, then he should have to pay for it. Mm-hmm. If he says, well, I didn't have anything to drink, I was not under any illegal drug, does that get him off the hook? No,
well,
it should not.
This brings the next question then. If they're going to cause harm to people, and do you believe then that government collectively has the authority to deny you the right to keep and bear arms? What's your position on that? Do they have that right?
Well,
constitutionally?
Constitutionally, Americans have an absolute right to keep and bear any and all arms. I think that's a very simple
without restriction.
Answer. Without restriction.
Without restrictions.
Okay.
You're right. Now, however, as soon as you take those arms, whether it be a 22 or a
BB gun
or a rock or an automobile, and you harm someone else, okay, then you have stepped beyond your rights of freedom,
okay,
and you are fully responsible then.
This brings me to the next question then, in line with this. Assuming that an individual by accident harmed somebody, and it wasn't something that he intended, but nevertheless, it's done with a weapon or it's done with a car, but it wasn't something that was done intentionally, mm-hmm. then does government then still have the authority to punish you for doing something by accident that was an accident?
No,
and not something that you intentionally did?
You should have to pay for whatever you do, whether it's intentional or unintentional. Mm-hmm. If you cause harm to somebody, you should have to pay for it.
Right. So in other words, there's not really such a thing as an accident.
Well, an accident, if you want to define it as something, a harm that's brought about unintentionally,
mm-hmm.
then that could be called an accident. Still, you should have to pay for whatever your actions are. And if we flip that coin
or
over...
Or not.
Yeah, if we flip that coin over, by the same token, you should reap the rewards of your actions that produce money or whatever.
Okay, we're got this question. You didn't give me your position definitely on firearms.
A person should be allowed to own whatever firearms he wishes.
Okay.
He does not have the right to use it any way he wishes.
How would they, if placed in office, strengthen the California firearm owners' rights? If you are elected, how would you strengthen the rights of the Californians to keep firearms?
Number one, I would enforce the U.S. Constitution, the Bill of Rights, and that's exactly what I would do, as it stands.
Okay. Eliminate laws regarding the ownership of firearms.
You would vote to eliminate those.
Yeah,
arms.
Exactly. Yes.
Would you vote for legislation telling the judges, as an example, this is what this means, and this is what we, the legislature, say to you, the judges, the law is, and this is how you will rule on these cases?
If that makes the elimination of that law more effective, that would be fine.
Okay.
And furthers and strengthens the Constitution.
Okay. Why do many elected officials act as if they were elected to be volunteer of the year with our money? Where in our constitutions or charter do we authorize government to become a charity? And why do the government officials work so hard seeking nobility in giving away our money? Since the American people are the most generous in the world, do we really need government to be generous for us? Isn't it cheaper if we give our own money away to those things that we value?
It's not only cheaper, it's much more effective. You would have a much better system of helping people because you would not tend to give your money to something that you did not believe in, whereas mm-hmm. government does.
Well, now we have Lehman and Bronson and Costa and even to a degree Chip Pashaian voting. They seem to have an insatiable appetite to spend money they didn't earn and voting to give money away. What is your position on those four people?
They get reelected, and that's why they do that, because they get reelected. If they were not reelected, they would not things would be a lot different.
Okay, we have to take another break. Be back in just a moment, and I'll continue with questions for you gentlemen, but for right now, break.
Wake up all the teachers, time to teach a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say.
The power of teaching.
The world won't get no better.
The power to wake up young minds. The power to wake up the world. Teachers have that power. Reach for the power. Teach. I'm Edward James Olmos, and we're recruiting new teachers. Call 1-800-45-TEACH.
Are you sick and tired of seeing your insurance rates go up? I know I am. At LJ Linder & Associates Insurance Brokerage, they know how to do something about high costs. Call Larry and make an appointment today. He can help you fight the high prices and still get good old-fashioned personalized service. The following types of insurance are available: commercial, industrial, life, ocean, home, auto, farm, and hospitalization. That's LJ Linder & Associates, located at 4991 East McKinley,
Suite 118.
Call 252-3774.
From the tops of her mountains to the expanse of her beaches, South Africa is a veritable surprise package of new experiences, unveiling the best-kept secret in today's travel world.
If you have personalities in the news, I'm John Castle. If you have a question or an opinion, call it in, and it will be discussed. Our telephone number is 225-5959. Taking the calls this evening, Elisa Beach. Line is busy, but keep trying. She'll get to you in just a moment. I have with me two guests this evening, Mr. Roy Kendall and Dr. Hartoon Nifian. Roy is a real estate broker from Visalia, and the doctor is an optometrist from Visalia. They are both libertarians, and we are talking about the Libertarian Party. Also, I don't have with me my little bumper sticker that says no on Bruce Bronson, but since it is a paid announcement for no on Bruce Bronson, I'll bring it back again. The Americans for America are having an initiative, a petition drive, rather, to get rid of Bruce Bronson. So if you want to sign the petition, go over to the gun shop at McKinley and First Street, and that's Gilman over there, gun shop, and sign their petition. Now I got all the information in, so I don't feel too badly. Okay, John, please explain why you were bleeped when explaining why you were moving to another station. Well, again, so that you'll know, this time is going to be used for the Telemundo program. Okay, under the Libertarians, and now I'm back to my guess, under the Libertarians, do gays and lesbians have the right to flaunt themselves in the face of quote-unquote straight citizens?
Yes.
Okay, yes. And you believe that that whatever they are, that's what they are? Now, question then, do I have to associate with them whether I want to or not?
No.
Okay, am I required by law to work with them whether
no.
I want to or not? Am I required by law to hire them
no.
if I want to or not? Okay, but the law does say that you have to.
Yes.
As it present. Now, would you repeal that law
yes.
if you were elected? Okay. No, that's what I'm trying to find out is just exactly
basically,
where
basically, you should have the right to do whatever you want. The libertarian philosophy, let me make a point of this, that the libertarian philosophy is not a religious philosophy. It does not say what is right or wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Except with the exception of you have no right to initiate force.
Okay.
So aside from that, what is right or wrong is up to you to decide, not the Libertarian Party or anyone else.
Okay, if you were elected to public office, how would you handle it differently from the incumbent? What are some of the things that you would do differently from the present
okay.
incumbents?
Well, number one, we would institute a gold standard. We would
okay.
back our money up with gold rather than with strictly the taxing power of our government. Because right now, today, we are facing
enormous inflationary forces in this country from two angles. One is further involvement of the government in our personal lives and businesses has brought on a recession, and we will see continuing poverty and unemployment and homelessness in this country because of the government. The government involvement is not the answer. The removal of the government entrenchment in our lives and our businesses will be a solution to poverty, homelessness, okay, and unemployment. And as far as what else we would do, okay, there's just an entire list of items that we could go through item by item.
Okay, starting with Franklin Roosevelt, the paternalistic government sprang alive at that point, and it has continued to grow and grow and grow and grow to the point today that 52 cents out of every dollar in circulation is a government tax dollar. Mm-hmm. No matter who it is that spends a dollar, he's spending 52 cents of government money, one way, directly or indirectly.
Keep in mind that that 52 cents started from the people.
Right. Oh, I do.
Yeah, I know you do, but most people don't.
What is the Libertarian Party's attitude, then, toward abortion, prostitution, and legalization of drugs? Now, you've already said that you believe that if a person wanted to take drugs to the point that he died, that was his right. What about, then, the prostitution and abortion?
Well, again, these are moral questions that the person must decide whether abortion is moral or not, or whether prostitution is moral or not. But I have no right to impose my beliefs onto that other person.
Okay, let's go back to abortion for a moment. Doctor, are you saying that killing a child is a matter of belief for the person that does it, and therefore has that right, and therefore should not be challenged on it?
First of all, you have to define when that person is a person. Is he a person at birth, or is he a person at conception? And this is
okay,
a major problem.
If he is
a person at conception, then we are taking another life the same as we are taking another person who's been born.
Well, I'm not going to ask you for your personal belief at this point. Well, okay, what is your personal belief?
My personal opinion is right now that the state of California, if those people that are anti-abortion wish to find a very wide public forum, they could sue the state of California tomorrow in the state court over the issue of a pregnant woman who has is carrying one or two fetus or babies, however you want to look at it, okay? And if the state of California right now does not consider a pregnant woman more than one person.
And yet, I can show you case after case after case where deputy district attorneys stumble all over themselves, jump up and down, fall down, getting to the book to charge an individual that has a wreck and kills a pregnant woman and a child with two murders. You've said that the court says that they're not a child.
I'm saying that
they're
state,
not alive.
There's
the
a conflict.
The state of California has a conflict in that a woman applying for Section 8 rental housing assistance who is pregnant with twins, for example, is considered only one person, according to the housing authority, not three persons.
Yet, but according to the welfare, the moment that she is judged to have conceived, she can draw welfare money for her and, well, for the pregnancy.
Mm-hmm. Now, what we have is an enormous involvement of the government into our personal lives. I would not be one bit surprised to see government-mandated condom use to restrict the spread of AIDS in our society.
What about prostitution? That's in here, too. That's part of the question.
Well, as far as abortion goes, most libertarians would agree that the individual would have the right to an abortion, and prostitution, in the vernacular sense of the word, is, of course, a matter of agreement between consenting adults.
Okay. With respect to the removal of judges who rule initiatives unconstitutional, how would you answer the question previously asked if that violation limited the nature, scope, and extent of governmental power or activity? The problem is that California courts, as in Daley versus the city of Atascadero, has declared that the citizens do not have the right to limit government taxing and spending. Where does any judge get the authority to tell us that we cannot control our own government? In this respect, we are not talking about Proposition 103, in which one citizen, the premium payer trying against another citizen, in the insurance companies. They're talking about the Atascadero case in this case, where they ruled that you didn't have the right to control your elected officials in your government and how they taxed and spent money. Now, this is a judge that did that.
Yeah, I would assume
this was three judges that did that. Andreen wrote the decision, and it was upheld or by
at what level was this?
It was up here in the Fifth Court
State
of Appeals.
Okay.
Yeah. And Andreen and Franson and Zinovich, mm-hmm. concurred in by Franson and Zinovich, but Andreen is the guy that wrote the decision, well. if I recall correctly. Okay, why is the Ku Klux Klan allowed to march and parade in the city of Clovis, and we have the same right in the city of, and not the, have the same right in the city of Fresno? Are these citizens ordinaries that are different, ordinances that are different? Are these city ordinances different?
In other words, I'm not familiar with the individual ordinances, but anybody should have the right to do, to say whatever he wants. He has that constitutional right by freedom of speech. He does not have the right to go and burn somebody's house or anything else.
Well, neither does anyone, regardless of what group they belong to. What is the Libertarian Party's position on resistance to government that has turned on its citizens?
Well, we have the right to resist government. We have the right to...
In what way?
Any means that is lawful.
Yeah, the Libertarian Party position is a nonviolent reaction to government.
Yeah.
If government decides to take you and throw your back in into a concentration camp, whether you like it or not, mm-hmm. and they're doing it unconstitutionally and illegally, as far as you're concerned, are you going to let them do it, or are you going to resist?
You have the right.
And if you resist, how are you going to resist?
Okay,
that's the question.
That is up, again, the Libertarian Party would say that is up to the individual to resist or not resist as he so chooses. If he resists, he's going to have to pay the consequences of that, if there are any, or he's going to reap the benefit of that resistance if he is successful.
Take, for example, a citizen's resistance to the income tax laws.
Mm-hmm.
We have one of the leaders in our California state party right now, Jim Lewis, who has chosen individually, okay, to resist income tax laws and has spent 9 months in jail for his resistance. This was his choice.
Okay, our time is up, and I had one on Bruce Bronson spending $900,000 for a volleyball court, but our time is up. Ladies and gentlemen, tune in again next Saturday night when Personalities in the News will be over on Channel 49, KNXT-TV, same time, 7 o'clock. John Castle wishing you all...
The foregoing program does not necessarily reflect the views of the management or ownership of KMSG-TV. This program is not intended to present the opinions of KMSG-TV or Singer Telecasters Incorporated, nor does it represent station policy.
Pushes on every corner, crack babies, killing babies.
Mama?
Take this down to the funeral parlor. No, I'm going with you. I had my eyes shut when they got Jimmy, but I'll be damned if they get their hands on you.
I see trees of green,
red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed days, the dark sacred nights, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
If you're not recycling, you're throwing it all away.
Of person who'd rather tune an engine than eat, who reads a tachometer like a love story, for whom the roar of fully blown horsepower is a lullaby, have we got a machine for you. And in the hands of the right mechanic, it'll blow the doors off anything. Aim high, Air Force.
Session of our show here on Channel 59. Just as John Castle mentioned previously on his show, my show and also Country Concert, the great show put together by Ken Ferreira and company, and also the Fresno Mission Show and the Sports Hour and G. Michael's Sports Machine are all coming off of Channel 59. I think tomorrow night at 11 o'clock is the last time you'll see the Sports Hour, and then that will be it for all those shows. It is a decision of the new management to do this. They are going to be taking all Spanish-speaking TV from now on, Telemundo. And we will wish them the best of luck. We really do. It's it's a sad time for us, but then again, it's the way it goes. And we know you're going to enjoy Telemundo. It's a great network. And I hope Gil Garcia Patron, I hope you watch his show. That show is great, whether you watch it in Spanish or English. And have a good time with that. We have a great show planned for you tonight. We'll be taking calls from the audience. Ray Appleton is our guest, and we're going to be talking about all different kinds of things tonight. But I do want to take just a few minutes here at the top of the show to thank some people that I've worked with. And I'm really going to miss these people. I've worked proudly with these people over the last number of years, and I'm going to get right to it, and I'm going to say thank you to David Cardoza, who is the engineer in there tonight, and David is engineering this, so I hope the sound's going all right and the lighting's okay, because I'm going to say something good. David's a great guy. He's really worked hard for us, and David, I want to tell you, be sure and wear that Bronco jacket on Monday, okay? No matter what happens tomorrow, wear that Bronco jacket on Monday. Good. Okay. Feeling low, another great guy. He's a director and a producer here at the show. He's been really great to me. Lets me make fun of his name. The first time I met him, I said hello. He said, my name is Feeling Low. I said, well, I hope you're feeling better. And he said, no, my name is Feeling Low. And I said, yes, and I hope you feel better. But anyway, he's a great guy too, and I really appreciate it. John Thacker, who's standing right on the other side of the camera, has been down here every Saturday night. Thank you, John. He's doing a great job. Nozomi Matsumoto.
Hey.
Where are you from, Nozomi? From Japan? She's from Japan. She's an exchange student here going to Clovis West High School. She's done a wonderful job for us. Lois McPhail, who has answered the phones for us on so many occasions, so many nights. Thank you, Lois. And Julie Civic is answering the phones tonight. Dennis Silvas, what can I say? Dennis has been with me since the old 59 Tonight show. He's done a great job. He's come a long way. He's one of the best television production people in Fresno at this time. Let's say thanks to him and his brother Jeff, Chris Molia. I'm starting to talk fast because many times, Chris Molia, thanks a lot. He's been with me since the 59 Tonight show. Keith Allen, I'm amazed at what a great job he's done as program director here at Channel 59. Jennifer Perez, there's nobody prettier, there's nobody nicer. She's the receptionist out front. Thank you, Jennifer. Kenny Kirkpatrick, you rascal, you're always hassling me, give me a rough time. It's been great working with Kenny. Jim Zahn is the best general manager that anybody could work for. He's just a terrific guy. He is also leaving Channel 59. He's going to remain as an owner, but he's not general manager, but he's certainly general manager in everybody's heart. He's been great to work with. Marlene McKessian, thank you so much for being such a great person to work with. Carol Colbert laughed at all my jokes. That's amazing what Carol did. She's really terrific. And finally, Gary Cocola. And Gary, just want to say thank you so much for all the opportunity that you have given me over the years, and also for the inspiration you've given me over the years. I think Gary's got one of the best television minds in this whole area. He's taken the station from literally nothing and built it up into a great place. Every time that somebody comes in this building, they just know that Gary's done a terrific job. Thanks for the opportunity. He's a great coach, and a great coach, of course, puts together a good team, and that's what has gone on out here, a great team of people. Thanks for the support and the friendship. Thank you, sponsors. Thank you, Steve Valentine of Valley Cellular. I hope you buy your cellular phone from Steve. John Schaefer and all the wild and wacky staff over there at Whitey's Pet Shop, and Bob Seligian of Martin's. It's the prettiest shop in Fresno, without question. And hope you keep trading at these places. And of course, the viewers, thank you for the cards that you've sent, and the comments, and the calls. Let's see, was there anything else? No, really, thank you, everybody, for being so nice about this show. We've had fun doing it. We're going to do it again. We'll do it someplace else. We're going to take a short break right now, and then we're going to come back, and we're going to hit those phones early tonight because we know we got a lot of people that want to talk to Ray Appleton. So don't go away. We'll be back in 30 seconds. Right back.
The kind of person who'd rather tune an engine than eat, who reads a tachometer like a love story, for whom the roar of fully blown horsepower is a lullaby, have we got a machine for you. And in the hands of the right mechanic, it'll blow the doors off anything. Aim High Air Force.
Martin's Silk and Dry Flower Shop has made the difference in the total look of our home. Like our dining room, office, bath, bedroom, and den. All gorgeously decorated with Martin's silk plants and arrangements. Let Martin's give your home that special look. Martin's Silk and Dry Flower Shop in Fresno and Visalia.
Thank you. We are back. We're going to open up the lines now, 435-5900, 435-5900, if you have a comment for our guest, Ray Appleton. Did I talk too fast during that first segment?
I thought you were having a heart attack. Why don't we do this show from my house every Saturday?
There you go. All right.
Great idea.
Yeah. Hey, you know, it's great to, first of all, your beard is committed all the way. That's
I've had it forever. I just keep it short, but I let you get away with that comment. It makes you feel good, you know.
Oh, there you go. Yeah. Hey, I listened to your show the other day, and you were sick. Now you're all better.
Feel a little better.
Good.
A little hair out of the dog, you know. Works every time.
There you go. Yeah. Okay.
But sorry you're leaving. I hope you can resurrect this somewhere else.
Well, I'm sorry,
too. We need a local live TV talk show.
Well, I tell you, we've really enjoyed it a lot, and of course, there's been a lot of controversy going on lately. A lot of people say that what's happened here could make Peyton Place look like Sesame Street, but you know, it's just a decision of the management, and we really do wish them
a lot of luck. I do know your numbers are good. Your rating, Gary told me you got numbers. You got ratings, pal.
Well, it's been great. It really has. And when you're the time you were on the show, boy, we really did well.
We had fun.
We had some great shows. Like fun. Santa Claus was on the show. Toxie Cathy was on our Christmas show. Did wonderful
Who?
Job. Toxie Cathy.
Who's that?
Toxie is the fellow who plays Santa, and he...
Oh, okay.
And there's no...
I think I said Toxic.
Toxic.
It's like the Toxic Avenger or
Toxic.
Something.
There's nobody plays Santa like Toxic. I think Toxie really is Santa. I'm not sure. Followed him around one night, but then. Anyway, so how's everything going on the show? Your numbers are right through the roof.
We had an excellent rating period. In fact, we found out that, I say we, because many of us, you know, put together the show, or the highest rated local radio talk show for its time slot in the country, in the entire USA.
No kidding.
So, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
What a year. First he wins the best like disc jockey, not disc jockey, radio personality. Radio personality on Fresno, according to the Fresno Bee, and now number one in
we're
the
doing
nation.
All right. We're doing all right, yeah.
We going to be syndicating here, big guy?
My lips happening? Are sealed. Well, last time I said something about that, went back to my restaurant, got slapped by my employer, so I know nothing.
Okay.
I know absolutely nothing.
Well, you know what I think it is? I think you enjoy yourself. That's what it is. You really have a good time.
I have a ball. Yeah, it's very easy for me. I enjoy it. And you do, too. You're the same way.
I mean, well, I love it.
It's like breathing, you know, talking to people.
Say, they don't have any openings over there at Camden?
No, they don't, Chris. I'm really sorry.
I can talk about sports, knitting. But anyway, everything's going fine?
Everything's going well.
Does it bother you to get in the middle?
We had a tough week last week, but everything's going well.
Well, I wanted to ask you about that. Do you have a tough time? Does it really get you upset when you get in the middle of a big controversy? Because obviously there's a lot of things that people want to talk about, and obviously people have things on both sides of the fence. Is that tough for you personally?
What, taking a position?
You're in the middle. You know, you're kind of like you're.
Well, no, I'm not really in the middle. I mean, I'm in the middle as far as if I'm doing a show that has two sides, but I have my own opinion.
Well, what happens when you're talking about something that you have an opinion on, but yet job is to present both sides as much as you can to make it fair, right?
Yeah, but you're reading into it. You're making a mistake that a lot of the listeners do. I mean, it's my program, and my views are my views. And it's kind of a situation where I'm damned if I do and I'm damned if I don't. We'll get a number of calls if we have a real hot issue on. And if I don't take a position, they'll call up Appleton's wishy-washy, blah, blah, blah. If I have a brain explosion like I had about four or five times this week, I get letters in the mail, we get phone calls into the management. He's not supposed to have, you know, an opinion. He's not supposed to have a brain. He's supposed to sit there with no brain activity whatsoever. So, I mean, whatever moves me, and it's all very real.
Sounds like I know Rush Limbaugh is a name down there that causes. You just mention that name and people start to go up with a phone or something.
Well, he's very good at what he does. I mean, he's one of the best. You know, he can antagonize. That's kind of his act, though. I mean, he has no guests. I have guests, so the guests can antagonize or spit their position out and cause an antagonistic reaction with the audience. But that's just Rush one on one.
You know, speaking of phone calls, I want to say one more time, it was 453-5900, because once we get started, like last time Ray was on, once we get started on calls, I mean, you better get at the front of the line, because, and that does happen a lot. Does that happen to you?
They're all putting their bets on the Super Bowl tonight.
I hope they're betting on the David Cardoza. I want to hear the 49ers. I think the 49ers are going to win by as much as they want to.
Give me a score.
They're going to either win by, if they want to win by 10, they'll win by 10. If they want to win by 80, they'll win by 26, 27.
Nice attitude. I hope you're right.
Is that what you think?
I think it'll be about like a 45-14 type game.
I got the playoff game against the Rams when it was 30-3. Mm-hmm. I got about 30-3, 27-3.
It'll be a good one.
Yeah.
The Joe Show.
Oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, what a year that guy's had, huh?
He's doing well. Yeah. He's a nice man, too. We had him in town about 84 for a couple of personal appearances, and he just kind of hangs out, you know. He's not superhuman.
Was that out there at the Madera?
At one of the cook-offs when I was with the FM, yeah.
Yeah.
Not as big as you think either. Kind of a lanky guy.
Yeah, they say he's 6'1".
I don't
calls
buy
are starting
that.
To line up. They say he's 6'1", but I heard he was smaller than that.
Yeah.
You know what? I don't believe this, but I noticed the phones are going green, 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 and then they go blank, 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 blank.
Are you having little phone problems?
I think we had this a couple weeks ago. Same doggone thing happened. But keep trying, would you? It's 435-5900. 435-5900.
You know, that's my biggest nightmare.
The phone's going?
Yeah. It's
of course,
never
I've heard it
happened.
Happen to you.
I have one bank of phones that's like for on-air guests, and then another bank that's for the listeners. And the listener bank of phone lines has never gone out. I've had the on-air.
Oh, the guests. Okay, that's what I heard one time.
But that's scary. When the phones go, it's never happened.
You know, but look at this. See, they light up. They go green, green, green.
Hit the thing here.
No, I can't. We got to, see, you just hung up on somebody. Let me try one, okay? Let me see what's happening here. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello, who is this?
This is Chris. Who is this?
Hi, Chris. This is Saul Zeppelin.
Saul Zeppelin, how
Saul
are you?
Saul Zeppelin.
Fabulous.
I love Solly Zeppelin.
two of my favorites in the world of broadcasting together tonight. I'm watching you out here at the Easy 8 Motel.
You're still at the Easy 8? That's great.
Oh, it's fabulous. Great rates out here, I tell you. I got the hot plate going. and I'm looking at you guys here while I'm lying back on the vibrating bed and the exciting 12-inch color television set. It is fabulous.
Sully, we love you. I haven't talked to you in years, man. It's been a while.
Sol makes the greatest chili in that hot plate. How's little Richie doing?
It's little Chico, get it right.
Boy, you know your phones are broken if he's on a line.
Yeah, now how did you do this? All the lines are busted and we got the one coming from the EZA. What's going on here?
I have no idea. I think I have to put another quarter in the phone here. Just a second. Boy, you're moving uptown, Terrence. Look at that zip. Nice.
Hey, huh?
It's really artsy. They're all black. Fabulous, fabulous.
Good idea, huh?
Well, I thought I would just call and say goodbye to you. And say hello again to my friend, Mr. Appleton, there.
Mr. Zeppelin, it's good to hear from you.
Yeah, it's nice to talk to you again. I guess I'll see you guys down the road, huh?
All right, you take care, Zal.
All right, bye-bye.
See ya. What a guy. That, of course,
it's a long story I don't want to go into.
Ken Parks used to be on our show here on 59 Tonight, and he's a great character actor. He does so many different
characters. He does some real
characters.
Good
characters, yeah. Now he's over at The Good Company. And
is he really?
He's in Good Company.
I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah.
This is like a little chit-chat show tonight, isn't it? You know, no issues, no heavy stuff.
Well, let's talk about some food.
Like what? What would you like?
The Taj Mahal. Let's talk about the Taj Mahal.
Where's the camera?
Yeah.
Oh, over here. Hi, guys. Yeah. It's there. They're doing it. Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Good. So anyway, we are definitely hitting a phone.
This is real good.
Here.
You know, your last show and your phones go out here.
Yeah.
Is that a new management ploy there?
I just don't know how that works. I mean, it goes like the three green ones line up.
Why don't you push something
and
again
the,
and we'll see what happens, you know?
All right, let's try it. We'll probably be Saul again.
No.
Saul. Like, no, I'm telling you. Okay. So, let's talk
Maybe
about...
Maybe people don't like me anymore. Maybe that's it.
Now, you know that's not true.
That's it. Right.
That's not true. Mm-hmm. Do you have people who call you and get on your case about something Rush Limbaugh said? Does that happen?
Not as much as was the occasion. Yeah, that doesn't happen nearly as much anymore. Some people say we're beginning to sound like each other, which scares me a little bit. But
let's try a couple more of these, okay?
Oh, looks like Christmas Tree Lane here.
Definitely have
Ma Bell just came to life.
Problem with the phone. Hello, can you? Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Chris.
Yes.
Hi, this is Dee Boy. How are you?
Hello, Dee. How are you?
It's been a long time.
Yes.
I feel like Ralph Edwards, and this is my life. Hi, Dee.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing well. I need a new formal for the prom, honey.
Come on in, and we'll get you all straightened up.
I'm sure you can.
I wanted to just say hi and wish everybody luck over there. And I'm just turning my channels here and saw you, too, and I said, I've got to call in and say hi. So wish the best of luck.
Well, that's great. Thank you, Dee.
Okay.
Take
it easy.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
We're going to take a short break, and we're going to get to this phone call. It's 435-5900, 435-5900, and we'll be back in 60 seconds.
Martin's Silk and Dry Flower Shop has made the difference in the total look of our home, like our dining room, office, bath, bedroom, and den. All gorgeously decorated with Martin's silk plants and arrangements. Let Martin's give your home that special look. Martin's Silk and Dry Flower Shop in Fresno and Visalia.
He's headed for the desert.
He was always hard-headed.
But, Dad, I'm not into rocks. Rock music.
The lizard is talented. He's booked.
Las Vegas?
He's good. I've caught his act. Ooh.
He could be great. Rock the big time.
Hey, you the rock act?
Rockabilly, dude.
Whitey's Pet Shop, where pets are celebrities.
Mamas like you make my job so easy when you don't tell your children just how deadly crack is. But my baby's too young, you say. Yeah, and I'm hooking them younger every day. But they don't have the money, you say. Huh. Once my customers get hooked on crack, they lie, cheat, and steal to get more. So thanks for not telling Junior about guys like me. I just love getting first crack out.
Okay. Okay, we are back with Ray Appleton. We just had Mitch from the phone company came in, fixed things up.
Thank you, Mitch.
And
we're really glad we got an Edsel we'd like to sell you.
There you go. But before we start taking calls real quick, I want to say this fellow is going to be on the show next week. His name is Phil Christian. I've had the pleasure to talk with him quite a bit over the past couple months. I love this album. It's a great album.
It's a good
album.
One. It's
really good,
one, good
album. He's done a lot of things in the music world. He even played with Cheap Trick. He toured, toured with Cheap Trick.
He's also a boxing fan, too, which makes him a real human being.
Right on.
Yeah.
Phil Christian is the name. The album is great. You can get it at Tower Records or Warehouse. And if you can't, give us a call, and we'll help you get it. Let's start taking calls live. Hello.
Hi, Chris.
Hi, who's this?
This is Gloria Robinson.
Well, hello, Gloria. How are you?
I'm fine. I'm sorry to hear this is your last show, and I'm sure enjoyed the show, and wish you the best.
Well, thank you so much.
Okay.
Take care, Gloria.
Yeah, you too.
Bye-bye. Bye. Well, that was nice to hear from Gloria. Now, let's see. I think I... Okay, we're going to try this line. Hello.
Hello, Chris.
Yes.
My name is Paul. I'm calling from Zorba the Greek. I just wanted to say hello to Ray Appleton.
Hello there.
So, I'm watching you now from my restaurant, Farmer's Market, and I wanted to say...
Oh, I know who you are.
Oh, thank you.
Giros.
Yes.
Wonderful stuff.
I'm listening every afternoon. I have always KMJ afternoon.
Uh-huh.
And I'm a very good fan and supporter to Fresno State Foundation and everything, Bulldog Foundation. Anyway, I just wanted to say that all those topics that you are discussing on the KMJ radio, I'm in. I mean, I support your opinion, and you are very conservative somehow. Also, that Rush Limbaugh, sometimes. I mean, some of those topics, they are getting my nerves. But I love him completely for his opinion and some of his funny comments. But I've never seen you. It's the first time that I see you live on television. Somehow,
first time you've
someday
seen me
when
dead
you come
on
to my place, I want to give you an offer, like a free dinner or a...
Hey, there
offer.
You go.
I know you like yours, but I want to give you something better than yours, like a super dinner.
Okay. I would love to come down and see you.
Sure.
Hey, well, thank you for calling, Paul.
Okay, I'm watching every day your show late night because I go about midnight home, and I'm watching all these beautiful shows. Plus, I'm an export pro, so I'm watching that sports machine over there.
Oh, great. Yeah, that'll be on tomorrow
sure.
night. 11
Keep
o'clock.
It going.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks for calling.
Hey,
take
care.
You.
Got hello. Good food. I've eaten
oh,
there before.
Oh, what a
great place. Giros.
Hello.
Hello, Chris.
Hello.
This is Ron Riding.
Hello, Ron. How are you?
Well, I was surprised to hear about you leaving again.
Well, what can I say?
Again.
I remember Ron used to call in on the old 59 Tonight show, right?
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember Mr. Parapacino and Ken.
Mr. Parapacini and...
The old gang.
And Saul Zeppelin and everybody.
Yeah, Saul.
Well, Ron, thank you for the call. I really appreciate it.
Oh, what I was going to ask you, ask your guest, does he feel that Rush Limbaugh could be the Howard Cosell of radio?
The Howard Cosell of radio.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll take the answer live on the air. Thanks, Ron.
Okay.
Okay. No. How's that for the answer?
Okay. Let's go to line two. Hello. Hello. You know, these phones. Okay. That was fun.
Delhi is a communist
plot. Let's go back to line one. Hello? No. Okay. They're off. So, anyway, Phil Christian. also wanted to say sorry to Brian Setensich, who was going to be on the show in 2 weeks. Brian is, of course, the very, very terrific basketball player, mm-hmm. and he's going into sports broadcasting. Did you know that?
I did not know
yes.
that.
Well, he's very, very good at
somebody
it.
Somebody else after my job.
There you go.
Oh, that's right. I don't do sports. I forgot.
But you do have a good, you have the right team tomorrow. Okay. Hello, line one. Okay. Line one, apparently...
Is John Castle out playing with the phone lines here?
Yeah,
John Castle's cut.
Where's Castle? About this.
John, are you still here?
Okay, line one. Let's try it again. Hello?
Yeah. I'd like to know, when Ray Appleton's on the television, on the radio, like, he seems to just get talking at the first part of his program all the time, and shoot, he doesn't get in talking on the telephone to people calling in for like 20, 30 minutes sometimes.
That's true. That's
he
true.
Loses a whole bunch of people, I always think, and doesn't get quite the comments I think would be enjoyable.
Well, let me tell you what happens there. People normally on let's say, a very interesting show don't usually call in until about 20 minutes into the program. When we got calls, we go straight to them.
It's just, that's what happens.
Takes
tonight.
A while.
That's what happened tonight.
It takes a while to set up.
You got to warm up a little bit.
Yeah, sometimes there are calls like the other day I had on one of my favorite people, Colonel David Hackworth, who is the most decorated military man living in our history. And we had calls from right there.
Yeah.
And we got to him as quick as we could. But usually it takes about 15 minutes, 20 minutes for the phones to warm up. That's
thank
why.
You. Thank you for the call. And here they come, speaking of the calls. Hello.
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 Oh.
Hello.
Why don't you get on with the show?
Okay, we'll get on with the show.
All right, we'll get on with the show.
What did you want to talk about?
I'd like to hear some comments.
On?
I'd like to hear some comments.
Okay, we'll get to some comments. We got some coming in right now.
Okay.
Thank you.
Somebody from the phone
my
company,
brother.
No doubt. No
hello,
doubt.
Hello, line three.
Hello, I just wanted to set the record straight. It's going to be an Elway show, no Joe show.
Oh, another Bronco fan. Is this David Cardoza calling from the engineer?
No.
Well, I'll tell you what, I hope the Broncos give them a game, because the thing is that the last two times the Broncos were in the Super Bowl, you know, both times were kind of an embarrassment, you know. So
yeah.
I hope they do give them a game.
Joe
I really
Montana's
do.
Too old.
Who?
Joe Montana's too old.
Oh, no. Joe Montana.
You see him fall to the ground when they're about to tackle him?
He is at the top of it. No. You have him confused with Jim Everett. Jim Everett was the one who hit the
You have him confused with George Foreman.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, thanks for the call.
Yeah. Bye.
Bye. Boy, you know, that's going to be a great game tomorrow. That really is.
I hope it is a great game.
A lot of people are excited about it.
I think
it.
There's so much hype, you know, that everybody thinks it's going to be so lopsided. I think it's really, and I'm a big Niners fan, but I think it's really pumping up the Broncos.
Yeah.
I think they're going to give it 110%.
Yeah. You know, isn't it weird when it gets down to this? You know, the same thing happened in the NBA last year when everybody was looking for the Lakers to play the Jazz.
Right.
That was going to be the great playoff. And the Warriors go and bomb out the Jazz in the first round.
Mm-hmm.
And then the Warriors get creamed by Phoenix. And then you got Phoenix and the Lakers and... You know, and then towards the end, it gets to the Pistons and the Lakers. But anyway, that's what happened. We got other calls here. Please, yes, hello, line one.
Hi, Chris.
Hi.
I'm going to miss you.
Who's this?
This is Lois.
Hi, Lois.
How are you?
How are you? Good.
I'm fine. And I'm going to miss you on your show.
Well, thank you very much.
And hello to Ray again.
Hello there.
How are you?
I'm doing well, thank you.
You look great.
Thanks.
You guys have
that.
A good evening.
Thanks, you too,
yeah.
Lois.
Bye-bye.
Take care. Oh, that's so nice.
You know, it's a nice, easy way for you to get out. You know,
yeah.
It's not heavy stuff like last time.
Well, yeah, last time, woo. But this has really been nice. You know, we could do a couple hours doing this, but I don't want to leave. Could we do another half hour?
Okay, yeah. We tried that last time. We got in trouble.
So what are your plans for the future? I wanted to ask you that before we leave.
My plans for the future. I can almost assure you that I will be at work Monday.
Come on, let's go.
Maybe Tuesday,
out with
if you're lucky.
What's off in the Appleton?
Absolutely
here?
Nothing. I will continue doing what I'm doing. It's all I want to do.
Right, you love doing it, huh?
Oh, yeah.
That's
yeah.
Great, right? We got to look at these phones now. Hello, real quick, line one. That was the...
That's the same guy still trying to order pizza. He thinks it's Domino's or
okay,
something.
Okay, let's try this. How about going to line two? Line two, hello.
Yeah, Ray, I was wondering, when are you going to get rid of Rush Limbo?
That's not my decision.
Do you know who you could talk to?
Well, you would want to talk to my marvelous employer who's watching right now named Al Smith.
Al Smith. All right, you got it.
Okay.
Thanks
enjoy
for
the show, man.
Thanks for the call.
I changed my prediction. I won't be at work Monday after saying that.
All right.
Thanks a lot.
Bye.
Can you believe it? We got to go.
Yeah.
Oh, got it. Now the Christmas tree lights are up.
Well, this was an exciting
thank
one,
you
Chris.
For being
best
here.
To you in the future, pal.
It's always good to
all
see
right.
you,
right? Yeah.
See you again soon. Thank you, everybody. We'll see. I'd say tune in next week, but, well, what the heck. Tune in next week anyway, okay? And we'll see you soon. Take care.
Every morning, Wally Bonfield rises just before the sun
Every morning, that is, since 1927, when he opened Bonfield Service Station. He's built his reputation by taking care of his customers, but along the way, he's taken care of himself. Wally buys U.S. savings bonds, the safe, reliable way to plan for retirement. A lot's changed over the years. Luckily, there's one thing he can count on, U.S. savings bonds. To find out more, call 1-800-U.S.-BONDS.
Keep smiling, keep shining, knowing you can always count on me, for sure. That's what friends are for good times and bad times. I'll be on your side forevermore. That's what friends are for.
There's a lighthouse on the hillside that overlooks life's sea. When I'm tossed, it seems out of line that I might see, and the light that shines in darkness now will safely lead us home. If it wasn't for the lighthouse, my ship would be no more.
Since 1949, the...